This video is made possible by Brilliant. Start learning intuitively with Brilliant for 20% off by being one of the first 200 people to sign up at brilliant.org/reallifelore. So you probably know that stars are pretty far away, but you may have also been dreaming about visiting one ever since you were a kid. Science fiction has taught us that traveling to a distant star system may not be too far off in the distant future, but science fiction rarely gets into some of the largest problems that surround this concept. I've made one video before discussing the possibility of humanity reaching another star in your lifetime, and to summarize that one, the best you can hope for is maybe a tiny probe reaching the Proxima Centauri system sometime in a few decades that might be capable of taking some pictures of the planets there. But as for you actually going yourself and visiting a planet that orbits a distant star, unless you can figure out how to become immortal, you likely never will, and here are some of the biggest reasons why. The distances are obviously huge, and traveling across those distances will take a lot of time. The fastest speed that humanity has ever achieved with a man-made object was using the Helios 2 probe, which got up to 240,000 kilometers per hour. That's fast enough to circle around the entire Earth in just about 10 minutes. But going at that speed would still take about 19,000 years just to reach Proxima Centauri, the nearest other star to the Sun. But let's speculate for a moment, though, that perhaps this is the fastest speed that we ever could reach using a spaceship with actual humans on board. We build a ship with about a 100-person crew that repopulates itself over generations until it gets to Proxima Centauri. This concept is known as a generation ship, and the people on board would live out their entire lives without ever leaving the small space of the ship. Before arriving at its destination, over 600 generations of people would live out this bizarre existence before finally arriving 19,000 years later at their destination and goal, the first humans to ever colonize another star system. The only problem is, though, is that after they finally do arrive, they not only discover that humans are already there, but have been there already for thousands of years, and have completely colonized the new planet with millions of people and huge cities. The reason this could happen is that the people of 2018 assumed that the speed of 240,000 kilometers per hour was the fastest speed we could achieve on a ship, and so they sent out their colonists under that assumption. However, after 1,000 years into their journey, they were still 18,000 years more away from getting to their planet. Back on Earth, though, 1,000 years of technological development was enough time to discover much faster forms of space travel, and the people of the year 3018 were capable of sending out colonists on a ship that could reach the planet in just 5,000 years. So their ship ended up passing the one launched in 2018, arrived at the destination planet thousands of years before it, and had enough time to completely develop civilization there before the 2018 ship arrived, and discovered their entire 19,000-year ordeal and suffering was all for nothing. Who knows what psychological or philosophical problems such an experience could create for those people, but this entire problem is known as the weight calculation. When is the optimal time for humanity to send colonists out to another star? The concept was first written about by Andrew Kennedy in a paper written in 2006. Kennedy assumed that there had to be a minimum travel time to any place in the universe, and that meant once our technology was close to achieving it, we could safely send colonists out and avoid the risk of leaving too early for nothing. But deciding when the best time to leave is pretty complicated, and think about the implications that poses to any would-be space traveler. Would you voluntarily sign up to be locked in a spaceship for the rest of your life, along with your children's lives and their children's and so on hundreds of times over, when the only payoff would be being told that one day humanity would colonize another star thanks to your sacrifice? But then you remember the weight calculation and realize that that only payoff is actually a huge gamble, and your sacrifice may be worthless in the long run. You'd be insane to take that risk, and everybody else would feel the same way, so convincing anybody to get on a generation ship like this at almost any time in the future would be almost impossible unless you force them to. Would-be colonists could always assume that people in the future would just create a faster form of transportation that would completely negate their own journeys. That is until we discover a way to travel at or near light speed. It appears that the speed of light is the universe's highest speed limit, and so naturally, if humanity ever discovered a way to travel near it, potential colonists could rest assured that their sacrifices and travel would never be in vain, like the explorers aboard the ABC Jungle Fruit, a cruiser searching for resources beyond Earth in a class on Einstein's special relativity over at brilliant.org. This course, like all other Brilliant courses, makes learning about complex topics simple by breaking down concepts into their intuitive principles and combining them to build up to an answer. Learning like this is the best method for me, and I'm sure for many of you as well. If you'd rather not learn about special relativity, then they have tons of other courses on topics like complex algebra, calculus, computational biology, and since you're watching this on a computer, computer science. Best of all though, you can try Brilliant for free by using the link brilliant.org/reallifelore in the description, and then the first 200 people to click that link will also get 20% off their annual premium subscription. Thanks to Brilliant for supporting Real Life Lore, and thanks to you for watching and checking them out.